Good evening, BZB, and welcome to Sleep Better Podcast by BZB's Honey, where we share special sleep stories to help you sleep better. Let's take a moment to acknowledge the incredible dedication and care you pour into each day. Your commitment to nurturing others is truly admirable, but tonight, this time is solely for you. It's your turn to be cared for, to be soothed, and to embrace the tranquility that you so richly deserve. Imagine for a moment the gentle embrace of serenity, wrapping around you like a soft, comforting blanket. Tonight is about letting go of the day's worries and immersing yourself in a world of peacefulness and rest. Remember, BZB, caring for yourself is not just a luxury, it's a necessity. Your well-being is the foundation from which you can continue to spread kindness and compassion to the world. This story, crafted especially for you, BZB, is a journey to a place where dreams blend seamlessly with reality, where the mind finds solace and the spirit is gently lulled into a state of blissful repose. So settle in, BZB. Let the world outside fade away as we embark on this peaceful journey together. Let's begin. In a small tranquil town where the rhythm of life was set by the rising and setting of the sun, Claire Green began her day. At the heart of this idyllic setting was her cherished garden, glistening with morning dew, a testament to her connection with nature. Claire, at 40, navigated a life filled with the warmth of family, the demands of a career she had nurtured from the ground up, and a personal quest for balance. Her home, infused with character and memories, was a haven for her and her family, two spirited teenagers and a husband whose steadfast support was her lifeline. The Green household was a blend of love, laughter, and the usual chaos of family life. Claire's mornings were early, a routine shaped by her role in a local business. Starting as an assistant, she had risen through the ranks, now holding a position that demanded not just her skills, but her heart and soul. Yet her career, as rewarding as it was, often left her in a relentless race against time, balancing boardroom strategies with family dinners. Her garden was her refuge, a space where she nurtured life in the soil, a parallel to her nurturing nature. Here, amidst the roses and marigolds, Claire found moments of peace, an escape from the relentless pace of her life. But this peace was often short-lived. Claire's nights were marred by restless sleep, a challenge that she carried with silent resilience. Her struggle with insomnia was her silent battle, a thief of energy and serenity. It was a challenge she was determined to overcome, exploring every avenue from self-help books to wellness influencers, seeking a natural solution that seemed just out of reach. As she prepared for the day, donning a simple yet elegant outfit, Claire's reflection in the mirror revealed a woman of strength, masking her fatigue with a hopeful smile. Known for her preference for direct, heartfelt communication, she was a cherished member of her community and a respected figure at work. Her belief in natural, safe solutions Claire's life was a perpetual balancing act, a dance between her roles as a mother, wife, and a key player in her company. The early mornings and late nights began to blur, each day a repeat of the last, yet filled with its unique trials. In the office, the new project she was leading was both an exhilarating opportunity and a daunting challenge. It required innovation, leadership, and a level of commitment that stretched her limits. The project, aimed at expanding the company's reach into new markets, was not just a test of her professional abilities, but a chance to make her mark. At home, her teenagers, navigating their own turbulent paths of adolescence, demanded attention and guidance. Her husband, though a pillar of support, had his own career to manage, often leading to a juggling act of schedules and responsibilities. Their family dinners, once a time of sharing and laughter, were now quick affairs, often interrupted by the demands of her work. Amidst this whirlwind, Claire's battle with insomnia escalated. Her nights were a cacophony of restless thoughts, her mind replaying the day's events and anticipating the challenges of the next. The lack of restful sleep began to take its toll, her eyes often shadowed, her energy levels waning. Yet, she pushed on, fueled by a mixture of determination and caffeine. The community events and health fairs that she once frequented became distant memories, her garden a neglected paradise, her once flourishing haven now mirrored her inner turmoil, untended and longing for care. As the project deadlines drew nearer, the pressure mounted. Claire found herself caught in a vortex of meetings, reports, and critical decisions. The stakes were high, and failure was not an option. The project was more than a business venture. It was a testament to her capabilities and a chance to prove her worth in a male-dominated industry. Amidst this professional storm, Claire's personal life began to fray at the edges. Her relationship with her children became strained, their conversations brief and often laden with frustration. Her husband, attempting to bridge the growing gap, found himself at a loss. His attempts at support often met with Claire's stress-fueled reticence. It was during this time that a figure from Claire's past reemerged. An old flame, a remnant of a life before responsibilities and ambitions took hold. His sudden appearance in her life brought back as autumn painted the town in hues of orange and red, Claire's life seemed to mirror the season's change, a transformation, both beautiful and tumultuous. The project that had consumed her for months was nearing its deadline, a culmination of endless hours, sleepless nights, and relentless pressure. The office was a hive of activity, with Claire at its center. The final presentation to the board and potential investors was just days away. This presentation was more than a business proposal. It was the embodiment of her hard work, her dreams, and her aspirations. The weight of expectation was heavy on her shoulders. each decision, each word she prepared, scrutinized by her own harshest critic, herself. At home, the atmosphere was equally charged. Her children, caught up in their own worlds, seemed distant, their interactions with Claire limited and often strained. The gap that had been widening over the months now felt like a chasm, her family's presence more like echoes in a hallway rather than the warmth she yearned for. Her husband, ever patient, tried to bridge the divide, but his efforts were met with a wall of stress and exhaustion that Claire had unwittingly built around herself. Their conversations, once filled with dreams and laughter, were now logistical exchanges, functional yet devoid of the intimacy they once shared. In the midst of this chaos, Claire's health began to falter. Her battle with insomnia reached a critical point. Her nights a battleground where sleep was the elusive prize. Dark circles under her eyes, a constant headache, and a feeling of perpetual fatigue became her constant companions. Despite her efforts to maintain a semblance of normalcy, her body and mind were reaching their limits. Then came the day that changed everything. Just a week before the crucial presentation, a major flaw was discovered in the project plan. A miscalculation that threatened to unravel everything she had worked for. The error was a blow not just to the project, but to Claire's confidence, her sense of competence shaken to its core. The revelation of the mistake was a public affair, discussed in a meeting room filled with her colleagues and superiors. The room, once a place of empowerment, now felt like an arena of judgment. The disappointment and frustration in the eyes of her team and the barely concealed doubts of her superiors were like daggers to her heart. That evening, Claire returned home, a shell of her former self. The house was quiet, her family's presence reduced to mere shadows in the fading light. She stood in her neglected garden, the once vibrant blooms now withered, a stark reflection of her inner turmoil. In this moment of despair, Claire faced the most challenging decision of her life: to continue fighting a seemingly losing battle, or to concede defeat, to let go of the dream that she had nurtured for so long. The weight of her world, her career, her family, her own identity seemed to crush her from within. But it was in this darkest hour that a flicker of light emerged. A phone call from her daughter, a simple inquiry about dinner, broke through her wall of isolation. It was a reminder of what truly mattered, a call back to the essence of her life. Claire realized that her struggle was not just about the project or her career. It was about finding herself amidst the chaos, about reconnecting with the things that brought her joy and peace. It was about her family, her garden, her health, and her happiness. With a newfound resolve, Claire made a decision. She would face the challenge head on, not just for the sake of the project, but for herself, for her family, for the life. The successful presentation marked a turning point for Claire, but it was just the beginning of her journey towards healing and balance. The applause and congratulations from her colleagues and superiors were affirmations of her professional abilities, but the true challenge lay in restoring the harmony in her personal life. In the weeks that followed, Claire took deliberate steps to mend the fissures in her family life. She started by setting aside dedicated time for her children, engaging in their lives not just as a mother, but as a listener, a confidant. Slowly, the conversations grew richer, the laughter more genuine, the connection stronger. Her relationship with her husband underwent a renaissance. They began to share more than just the day-to-day responsibilities. They shared dreams, fears, and laughter, rediscovering the love that had been overshadowed by the hustle of life. Their evening walks, a ritual they had long abandoned, became a cherished part of their day, a time to reconnect and reflect. Professionally, Claire's success with the project opened new doors. However, she approached these opportunities with a new perspective. She learned to delegate, to trust her team, and to balance her work with her personal life. The office no longer felt like a battleground, but a place where she could make a difference without sacrificing her well-being. Claire's journey to overcome her insomnia was gradual but effective. With the help of a sleep specialist, she adopted a routine that promoted better sleep, including reducing caffeine intake, setting a consistent bedtime, and creating a restful environment in her bedroom. She also explored mindfulness and meditation, practices that helped calm her mind and prepare her body for rest. Her garden, once a symbol of her neglect, flourished under her renewed care. Gardening became more than a hobby. It was therapy, a way to ground herself and find peace. The vibrant colors and fragrances of the blooms were testaments to her resilience and care. Claire also reconnected with her community, attending local events and health fairs, not just as a participant, but as a contributor, sharing her experiences and learnings about balancing life, work, and health. Her story resonated with many, her honesty and vulnerability drawing people to her. As the seasons changed, so did the rhythm of Claire's life. The relentless pace gave way to a more measured, intentional cadence. She learned to appreciate the small moments, the quiet joys that life offered. Her family noticed the change too. The stress that had once clouded her face gave way to a serene smile, her eyes reflecting the calm and As the year drew to a close, Claire found herself in a place of profound tranquility and satisfaction. The turmoil that had once defined her days had transformed into a harmonious balance, a symphony of work, family, and self-care. Her career continued to flourish, but it no longer consumed her. She had learned the art of balance, understanding that her worth was not solely tied to her professional achievements. Her leadership style evolved, becoming more inclusive and empathetic, inspired by her own journey of self-discovery. At home, the bonds with her family were stronger than ever. Her children, now more open and connected with her, shared their dreams and challenges, seeking her advice and comfort. The family dinners, once rushed and fragmented, were now lively gatherings, filled with stories, debates, and shared plans for the future. Her relationship with her husband had entered a new phase, one of deeper understanding and renewed passion. They became partners, not just in parenting and household responsibilities, but in life's adventures, big and small. Their love, tested and strengthened by the trials they faced, became the bedrock of Claire's life. Claire's success in managing her insomnia had a profound impact on her overall well-being. She woke up each day feeling refreshed and energized, ready to face the challenges and joys that awaited her. Her improved sleep also enhanced her focus and creativity, both at work and in her personal pursuits. Her garden, a lush tapestry of greens, reds, yellows, and purples, was a source of pride and joy. It became a community attraction, a place where neighbors would stop by to admire and find inspiration. Claire often shared cuttings and gardening tips, her garden a metaphor for her life, nurtured, vibrant, and full of life. Claire also became a local inspiration. Her story of overcoming adversity and finding balance resonating with many. She started a small group for working women in her community, a forum to share experiences, support each other, and find solace in the collective strength. Her story, once a personal journey, now became a beacon for others. The year ended with a community event, a celebration of togetherness and gratitude. Claire, surrounded by her family, friends, and neighbors, felt a deep sense of fulfillment. She realized that her journey was not just about overcoming challenges, but about rediscovering herself, about finding joy in the simple things, and about creating a life that was true to her values and aspirations. As she stood in her garden, the setting sun casting a golden glow on the blooms, Claire reflected on the past year. It had been a journey of transformation, a journey that taught her the importance of self-care, of prioritizing relationships, and of living a life that was balanced and meaningful. She understood now that life was not about avoiding challenges, but about facing them with courage and grace. It was about growing.